Hey guys, welcome back to another streaming session of Subnautica. We're on another episode. I'm kind of losing track. All I can keep track of is that we're on our third sea moth and our first Cyclops. Very excited to have our cool little own submarine, but we really need to explore to another wreck in order to get to the Powercell charging station that we can then have on our vessel overall. But I really don't feel like losing the Cyclops, so I think we're going to have to just kind of risk it for the biscuit with our sea moth and explore as much as we can. So let's go ahead and I guess do that and hope for the best. And of course for today's episode, it's mostly going to be exploration, harvesting materials, maybe some more storyline with the alien stuff. I'm not too sure, but we're going to find out.
Systems online.
Thank you.
Warning, maximum depth reached. Hull damage imminent. Maximum depth reached. Hull damage imminent. Maximum depth reached. Hull damage imminent.
Thank you.
Warning. Maximum depth reached. Hull damage imminent.
Damage to plant life on the seafloor suggests this may be the migration path of a huge, bottom-dwelling life form.
Welcome aboard, Captain. Warning, maximum depth reached. Hull damage imminent.
aboard captive. All systems online. conditions in this cave support a microcosm of unique, possibly predatory life forms. Detecting an artificial structure somewhere in the region. Integrating new PDA data. New blueprint acquired. Integrating new PDA data. Integrating new PDA data. New blueprint acquired.
Okay, first thing, we got a lot of magnite, that's great. Also, we got the Powercell second piece for the charger, so now we'll be able to charge the Powercells needed for the Cyclops, or the big submarine. So that's a big move, and then we also have the aerogel needed to make the prawn suit. Hesitant on the prawn suit, I kinda wanna see, because I know it can do some good drilling for overall a lot of those huge, big deposits of materials, but I think right now the Cyclops might be better, but I'm just really worried about it getting demolished by Leviathan, because we've already lost two sea moths, and even though a Cyclops might be better in terms of like getting and everything, let's just start by building in our base the charger for the thing. So let's move this over and let's build on our base some more, and we can do a water filtration system and another thing. Let's see if we have enough of that. But regardless, this is going pretty decent for this episode. I mean, obviously we saw that Leviathan come crashing out of the water to the top of the surface to grab our thing, and I had to go and retrieve it and repair it because it only knocked it down to 60%. So pretty decent overall.
A reliable power source is a critical step towards self-sufficiency. Consider keeping a photo journal of your achievements to motivate you in times of despair.
honestly, I'm pleasantly suppressed, like, or pleasantly impressed, because we have this water machine, we have this that's, like, adding a lot of energy and power, that's great, and then I have this set up right next to it, so we can get food and water from here, and then I'll store extra waters in there. That's definitely great long term. If we could do that on the Cyclops, that would be awesome. I'm not too sure though, but let's take some of these and have those for ourselves. But yeah, pretty good so far, honestly. And I think I'm gonna end the episode by building a prawn suit. I think that's the biggest thing, and we're gonna be charging up the Powercell batteries for our big adventures in the next episode with the Cyclops. I think I'm going to leave most things here, maybe just build some lockers there for some harvesting, but I really don't trust it, and I don't trust this game, so I don't want to lose everything when I'm on the Cyclops. So just some lockers. I'll keep the charging stuff here and build as many batteries as my heart desires, really, and kind of go from there. Yeah, I guess all I need is batteries and silicon, so that's great. I have plenty of that for sure, but I don't know where that. Oh, I think I put the power cell batteries over here. And let's get those all charged up then. But good work so far, folks. So the problem is, now I'm worried about flooding, and I wanted to build up and make it look cool, but I'm worried about flooding, and I thought we had a bunch of lithium somewhere, and apparently we do not. So that's kind of unfortunate, some might say. But I thought we had a locker full of lithium, but I guess we kind of spent it all, which is, you know, it's fine. Is what it is. But, yeah. Oh, let's build a prawn suit, of course. Let's do that by the end. See, there it is, speak of the devil. All the lithium that we want to need. Thank goodness.
aboard, Captain.
Jeez, well, that was trippy. I was like, wait, I can't move anywhere, so might as well just chop it. And glad I chopped it. Jeez.
Vital signs stabilized.
You already know what time it is. It's time to make this prawn suit, baby. Here we go.
Suit to feel a sense of limitless power. Prawn operators receive weeks of training to counteract this phenomenon. You will have to make do with self-discipline.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Okay, the feeling right now, pretty great. It honestly, it feels like an Avatar, but not the airbender, but the one with the blue people. It feels like when you get in one of those mech suits, but you're less of a bad guy. So, I think we're going to just park it kind of like here, because we don't want it to get destroyed. And that's how we jump. Okay, boom! And he sticks the landing. Hopefully no damage done to the base overall, but we're gonna hide it right here, because we do not need to be losing this guy anytime soon. Oh, we could dock it in there. We might want to do that, so let's do that. We're gonna go grab a power cell, and then we're gonna open up the ship and dock our prawn suit in there. Let's put some of those there. Let's walk on over, because I think we can only dock it if there's power in it. And then I still need to, I think I have the modification or the ability to add on like the drilling arm, but not the attack arm, which I think is going to be at least a little bit of importance to us. So yeah, let's just do it.
Systems online.
Great, well that's about it for today. I think we're gonna harvest a little bit more of the basic. Oh, sweet. That one's already ready. Well, this is clutch, but yeah, I think we're gonna keep adding onto our base, make it look really cool, really nice, and go from there. Oh, and it gives us salt? Heck yes, thank you. So we're gonna use that water right now, actually. Perfect. And then those are growing. Chinese potato plants are good to go. And we can drop two of them in there and one for ourselves to eat. This is honestly, yeah, this is looking great so far. I'm really proud of how far the base has come despite the two setbacks of the sea moths and like the one time dying. So I think, or two times dying, I'd say. So I think we're doing good overall. Progress is looking on the up, so we can be proud of that. But yeah, good work guys, and I will see you in the next episode. If you're watching live on Twitch, thanks for watching on Scotty Streams. And if you're watching on YouTube, where this will be uploaded and edited, it will be on Supreme Scotty. And if you're on YouTube, please like and subscribe. Have a great day, folks.